Hi everyone, welcome to my channel Pinnacle Study Group. In this video, I am going to start CMS. You know the full form of CMS is Convention on the Conservation of Migrated Species of Wild Animals. And the other name of CMS is called Bonn Convention. This topic is very important as far as environment topic is concerned. Okay, so let's start the CMS. Or Bonn Convention. Again, the full form is Convention on the Conservation of Migratory Species of Wild Animals. You know, what is CMS? It aims to protect terrestrial, aquatic, and avian migrated species throughout their ranges. Okay, so India ki ranges hai. Isme kisko protect karna? Terrestrial, aquatic, or avian migrated species ko. एंड कन्वेंशन जो है ये साइन हुई थी बोन जर्मनी में 1979 में, तभी इसका नाम बोन कन्वेंशन पड़ गया. ओके, तो सीएमएस वाज साइन इन बोन जर्मनी 1979 एज अ इंटर गवर्नमेंटल ट्रीटी अंडर द ईजिस ऑफ यूनेप. यू नो यूनेप की फुल फॉर्म है यूनाइटेड नेशन एनवायरनमेंट प्रोग्राम. एंड सीएमएस ब्रिंग टुगेदर द गवर्नमेंट ऑफ द कंट्रीज टुगेदर विच माइग्रेटेड स्पीसीज पास लाइक द रेंज स्टेट. And it lay the legal foundation to conduct conservation measures on a global scale. Clear? Next. The legal instrument under CMS may range from legally binding agreement to less formal memorandum of understanding and can be adapted to fit the requirement of each region. CMS is only worldwide convention. So this is important. It is only worldwide conventions that are found exclusively for the preservation of the migrant animals. The migrant animals ke liye this is the only convention. Next, ab isme baat karte hain appendices ki. You know CMS has two appendices listing migratory species to which conventions apply. To isme do tarah ke appendices aate hain, appendix 1 and appendix 2. Migrated species threatened with extinction are listed on appendix 1 and threatened with extinction. Ek red data book aati hai, to red data book IUCN ke under aati hai, wo alag topic hota hai. So migrated species threatened with extinction are listed on appendix 1 and parties strive towards strictly protecting these animals, conserving or restoring the places where they live, mitigating obstacles to migration and controlling other factors that might endanger them. So ye to ho gaya appendix 1 mein aayengi jo threatened with extinction. Okay, next, migratory species that need or would significant benefit from international cooperation are listed in appendix 2 of the convention. Clear? So ye difference hota why animals are listed in appendix 1 and appendix 2. So isme first hai threatened with extinction or second is that need or would significantly benefit from international cooperation. Ab isme baat karte hain COP13. So COP13 jo recent hai okay, so CMS COP was the first of the series of international nature related meeting in 2020 which will culminate with the United Nations Biodiversity Conference in the Kunming, China in October. So 2020 mein ye meeting held hui thi, which is expected to adopt a new global biodiversity framework jiska naam rakha gaya tha the post 2020 global biodiversity framework. Clear? To COP conference of parties 13 which was held in October in China, the name is Kunming, China. Next, there is some additional information on COP 13. So conference of parties, kyunki conference of parties hui thi CMS ki tabhi to ye topic news mein raha tha. Iska theme kya tha? Migratory species connect the planet. Okay, jitne bhi migratory species hai wo planet ko connect karte hain and together we welcome them home. And iska logo tha kolam, which is a traditional art form from the South India and which has been used to depict key migratory species. Aur iska mascot tha gibi. Gibi is a, you know, the greatest Indian bustard jo Rajasthan mein paya jata hai. Theek hai, logo kolam tha and a mascot tha gibi, which is a great Indian bustard found in Rajasthan. And this was the first CMS COP to be inaugurated by the host country head of the government. Next, there are some key highlights. The first is adoption of Gandhinagar Declaration. Okay, Gandhinagar again, Gujarat. which call for migratory species and a concept of ecological connectivity to be integrated and prioritized in the post-2020 global biodiversity framework, which is expected to be adopted at a United Nations Biodiversity Conference in November this year. Okay, sorry, October this year. So, ये all topic है. अब इसमें क्या-क्या decision लिए गए थे? Okay, ये आप 2021 के लिए important है. 10 new species were added to CMS appendix at COP13. अभी मैंने आपको बताया, there are two types of appendix, appendix 1, appendix 2. Okay, total 10 animals है, 7 appendix 1 में add हुए थे, और 3 appendix 2 में, okay? 7-1 and 3-2. तो उसके नेम मैं एक बार बता देता हूँ, आप इसको सर्च करिएगा. इसमें एशियन एलिफेंट, जैगुआर, ग्रेट इंडियन बस्टर्ड, बंगाल फ्लोरिकन, लिटिल बस्टर्ड, एंटीपोडियन एल्बेस्ट्रोस एंड द ओशियन वाइट टिप शार्क इन 1, एंड इन 2 द यूराइल स्मूथ हैम्पशायर शार्क एंड द टॉप शार्क वर लिस्टेड फॉर प्रोटेक्शन अंडर अपेंडिक्स 2 विच कवर माइग्रेटरी स्पीसीज दैट हैव unfavorable conservation status and would benefit from enhanced international cooperation and the conservation action. Okay, so there are some highlights and you have to study. So 7-1 and 3-2. Clear? Next, the relaunch of CMS Ambassador Program, where 3 CMS Ambassadors, इसमें 3 आते हैं, terrestrial आ गया, avian आ गया और aquatic species. तो इसी के लिए ही तो ये convention बनी है. Named to help raise awareness about the important work of CMS and the plight of migratory. And there are recognition of 7 migratory species champions, including Germany, India, Italy, Monaco, Norway, European Commission, and the Environment Agency, who were acknowledged for their generous contribution to the CMS initiative. So, यहाँ पर CMS और Bonn Convention की non parties और parties हैं, जो यहाँ पर blue one है, these are parties. इसमें India आ गया, okay? और non parties आप देख सकते हो, so these are non parties. Clear? And it has been compiled by over 10 institutions and numerous citizen scientists. And it assesses long-term trend, current trend, and distribution range size, and the overall conservation status of 867 Indian bird species. Okay, so this is our topic. And this topic I have very briefly taken. Please, you have seen why this topic was in the news. And Bonn Convention's main motive is what? Its main motive I have told you: terrestrials, aquatics, avian migratory species. प्रोटेक्ट करने, ओके. और ये बोन कन्वेंशन इसलिए कहा जाता है क्योंकि ये बोन में साइन हुई थी 1979 में, और इसके अंडर, ओके, दिस इंटर गवर्नमेंटल ट्रीटी विच इज अंडर द यूनेस्को. क्लियर? होप आई आंसर. एंड सो दिस इज अबाउट टॉपिक इन दिस वीडियो. थैंक यू.